After 3 weeks of back-to-back-to-back NVIDIA RTX 40 Super Series GPUs launching, I wanted to do one more video covering an actually brand new graphics card design, not just the GPU itself, but the cooler too. Since the RTX 40 Supers are a mid-tier refresh, they're not new GPU architecture or anything like that, a lot of the manufacturers simply took their existing cooling designs for existing RTX 40 non-Super GPUs, slapped them on the Supers, and called it a day. Which is totally fine, just to be clear, but when I visited MSI at CES and they said, hey, check out our brand new design for the RTX 4080 Super, which is the MSI Expert version, I said, I'd like to take a closer look at that.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. A very important thing to note before we get into my test results, and this applies to pretty much all the GPU reviews that you might have seen recently or ever, and that is ASIC quality, the quality of the actual GPU that is installed in whatever card you happen to get, or whatever card I happen to get and then test. There is always going to be some variance from GPU to GPU, even ones that are cut from the same wafer. Certain GPUs will be able to tolerate higher frequencies while running at lower voltage, whereas other GPUs require a bit more power to get the job done. As far as NVIDIA is concerned, as long as the GPU that is distributed to the add-in board partners can operate within a specific tolerance range, they're like, okay, it's just fine. But what that means for consumers and for graphics card reviewers is that even between two graphics cards of the exact same make and model, there might be some variance in terms of performance. So to shed some light on the performance of this card, and also to provide a little bit more of an explainer for why my RTX 4080 Super Founders Edition graphics card did not perform as well as some of the other RTX 4080 Super Founders Edition cards out there in the review space, and was sometimes beaten by my RTX 4080 non-Super Founders Edition, here's a simple slide comparing the average clock speed. And this is an average of averages for the entire set of tests I ran on both cards. And here you can see that my 4080 Founders Edition was averaging over 2,780 megahertz. Compare that to my 4080 Super Founders Edition, which is about 60 megahertz slower. And then we have the MSI Expert 4080 Super, which did manage to outperform my 4080 Super Founders Edition by about 20 megahertz or so. So even though the 4080 Super has a raw specs advantage with additional CUDA cores as well as slightly higher clocked memory, if the GPU that you're comparing it to is just running at a higher clock speed in general, as my 4090 non-Super Founders Edition was, which for me resulted in pretty much equivalent performance between my non-Super and my Super Founders Edition cards. So next up, to see how that clock speed difference affected my test results, here are a bunch of test results. I reran all my tests with the MSI Expert card. I did limit it to 1440 and 4K resolutions for the sake of brevity. Also, for the sake of brevity, I'm going to rest my voice. We'll just play some nice background music for you while we run through this set of tests. So those are my benchmarks, the 1440 and 4K ones at least. And if you watched my 4080 Super launch review, you probably noted that it wasn't very exciting. There was a very, very small performance improvement, but I was at least glad to see that my 4080 Super Founders Edition here, which I think was a little bit of a weak performer, was able to be surpassed in performance, generally speaking, by the MSI Expert. But if you're comparing an add-in board partner card that's a third-party design like this one to, say, the Founders Edition or a reference design card, what else besides performance can stand out to make a difference between those cards? There is aesthetics, of course, and this is a very nice looking card. And while aesthetics typically don't have any impact on performance, for some buyers it can be a pretty significant impact on which card they go with. That's usually if they're building a system with like a tempered glass side panel and they want everything to look real nice. I like third-party designs that add in functional features, and for me, the most functional feature to add to a graphics card is a dual VBIOS, and unfortunately, that's something that the MSI Expert does not have. I was a little bit disappointed, actually, to find out that there is no physical switch on the card that lets you jump back and forth between, say, an overclock and a silent setting, or something that can give modders and overclockers a little bit more flexibility in terms of setting up different profiles, or knowing that if they're going for a really aggressive setup with one VBIOS, they can always switch back to the other one as a fallback. Beyond that though, functionally speaking, there's also the cooling performance and the acoustic performance of the cooler that the third-party add-in board partner designed. And lastly, there is price. And unfortunately, price is also one of the downsides of this particular card, at least at launch. This card is going for $1,150. Yes, $50 off the price of the $1,200 RTX 4080 non-super, but also a $150 markup over the new $1,000 price of this card. I still think even for a $1,000 card that a $150 markup is quite a lot, and while MSI did put some extra work into the design and development and manufacture of this card, is it worth $150 to end users? Hopefully you guys will know in just a few minutes. So let's start off with the aesthetics of this card with a closer look, since it is a pretty cool design that MSI said very directly is inspired by the Founders Edition. They have the dual fan design with one fan positioned over the PCB and the GPU to cool those components. It has a vapor chamber as well that makes direct contact with the GPU and the memory. And then it has, of course, a fin stack out here with a pass-through area so that the second fan, which is positioned on the back of the card, can get lots of airflow across those fins to help dissipate heat. These are dual ball bearing fans, which usually means they should have excellent lifespan, as well as being on the lower end in terms of actual noise output. And the card has a really nice, clean, overall finished look thanks to the aluminum die-cast housing. And that is another thing that costs more money than, say, going with a plastic housing, so that's part of the added cost of this card. But it is also what gives it, I'd say, a fairly striking look thanks to its slate gray design and the way it has nice, smooth contact points between the back plates and the shroud itself. I definitely say MSI is going for a more serious, kind of professional look with this card, which they definitely pulled off. And it also does not have any lighting, which for some people is absolutely a good selling point. Of course, who cares how pretty a cooler's design is if it doesn't cool well, and the MSI Expert cools decently well, but it's not the top of the pack. Here again is a comparison of the average temperature seen with the 4080 Founders Edition, 4080 Super Founders Edition, and the MSI Expert. This is the average across all tests, and you can see that the MSI Expert was running just slightly warmer than the 4080 Super Founders Edition, hitting 61.9 degrees Celsius on average versus 57.1. Now 61.9C is a perfectly fine temperature for this GPU to be running at. It's just by comparison, it was running 3 to 4 degrees warmer on average versus the 4080 Super Founders Edition. So in that respect, for someone who's looking for the 4080 Super that's going to provide the maximum performance, both in terms of cooling and clock speed, the MSI Expert is probably not going to be the way to go. Of course, the cooler could make up for that by being nearly silent when in operation, and unfortunately, it doesn't quite do that either. During my gaming test, the fan speeds on both cards were getting up to right about the same RPMs, about 1300 to 1350. And at that speed, the dBA difference between the two was essentially negligible. We're at 38.8 dBA for the 4080 Super Founders Edition, 39.2 for the MSI Expert. So it is just ever so slightly louder at that same fan speed, although again, practically you're not gonna notice an actual difference between the two unless you're measuring it with a sound meter. And both cards, of course, feature that zero fan mode, so if the GPU is not hot, the fans won't spin and it won't make any noise. Okay, with all that said, let's jump back to the cumulative results for my benchmarks. We're looking at 4K performance right now with rasterization across the 9 games that I tested. And these are riveting results, people. 100.8% performance versus the 4080 Founders Edition, which we're using as the 100% 0 point. So yes, the expert was able to beat the 4080 Founders Edition, which I guess is an accomplishment compared to my RTX 4080 Super Founders Edition. But once again, the margin was pretty minimal. Here's a look at my ray tracing tests, also at 4K. Once again, the expert outperformed the 4080's Founders Edition, which it really is supposed to. It's supposed to be able to do that usually by 1 to 3%. But here we are 1.2% faster, which is a 0.4% improvement over the 4080 Super Founders Edition. Adding in the 1440 results, we can see the exact same result, 0.8% faster than the 4080 Founders Edition. So I guess it's slightly good that this card is less expensive than the $1,200 4080 non-super. And once again, back to the ray tracing results, where we were 1.1% faster with the MSI Expert. Again, up a bit from the Founders Edition card that I tested just a couple days ago. And here, of course, with the ray tracing tests, the AMD cards are falling down to lower in the stack. But here's the overall performance. This is with all 13 tests, so it's including rasterization and ray tracing, and we're including the prices of the cards. At $1,150, the 4080 Super MSI Expert Edition is way, way closer to the 4080 Founders Edition, the non-super, at $1,200 than the new 4080 Super, which is going to cost you about $9.55 cost per frame in my tests at least, versus the 4080 Super MSI Expert, which is at $10.91. And this is quite obviously the biggest downside to this graphics card. As much as you might like the look, as much as you might be okay with the performance that is often quite equivalent to the Founders Edition, but given that the whole theme with the RTX 4080 Super launch has been, sure, it's not like a big boost in performance, but it's $200 cheaper, having this card that's only $50 cheaper really sucks a lot of that like viability and potential for people to be like, oh, okay, that makes sense now, versus what was available before. Here's my last chart, the overall performance with cost per frame at 2560 by 1440. And yet again, the 4080 Super with the MSI Expert price tag at $1,150, just sitting a lot closer to that RTX 4080 Founders Edition, which we're supposed to be moving on from with its $1,200 price. And so in conclusion, for my review of the MSI Expert RTX 4080 Super, there are definitely things I like about this card. I applaud MSI's effort to put out an actual new card along with this launch, alongside a lot of the cards that are using existing cooling designs. I like the fact that they've gone with a die-cast aluminum shroud. That's one of the things about especially higher-end cards that cost upwards of $700-$800 or more, but I'll often see those cards with plastic shrouds, and I'm like, plastic just doesn't feel quite as nice. So they get a thumbs up for that. They get a thumbs up for the aesthetics of this new card. And in terms of performance, it's like fine. It's on par with what else is available. And really what it boils down to for this card is the $150 markup over the $1,000 price of the Founders Edition, as well as a lot of other entry-level, quote-unquote, RTX 4080 Super graphics cards. Especially with the lack of more functional added features, like I'd say in particular a dual VBIOS, it is really hard to justify that increase in price for this card. I think if this was selling for like $1,050, a lot of people would be like, oh, $50 for that if they really like the look, or if they're looking for something that's a little bit more professional or expert, I suppose. They probably have a lot more interest at that price. And I'm sure even at $1,150, they're gonna have some people that are just enamored with this and decide they wanna go for it anyway. But if you're one of the people who is trying to make that call on whether or not you want to invest in the MSI Expert version of the RTX 4080 Super, I hope this review has given you guys some more details and some more actual raw data to chew on in making that decision. But that is going to wrap it up for this video. I'd like to say a big thank you to you guys for watching. And also you can check the video's description down below for links to the graphics cards I talked about today, as well as a link to my store, paulshardware.net, where you can buy shirts, mugs, pint glasses, and all manner of high quality merchandise to help support my channel. If you guys want to hit the thumbs up button on your way out, that's greatly appreciated, and of course subscribe to my channel too if you're not already for more tech content like this coming at you real soon. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video.